The purposes of a SIPOC diagram are, number one, to provide an at-a-glance overview of a process in that center column there. You can always use a link icon to link to more detailed flowchart of the process. But the flowchart that appears on this SIPOC should be a very simplified process overview. And purpose number two is to define where do the boundaries of this process start and stop. And purpose number three is to clarify what are the inputs that go into this process and what are the enablers that are needed for this process. And then also, who are the suppliers of those inputs and enablers? And the fourth purpose of the SIPOC worksheet is to identify what are the outputs that come out of this process and who are the internal or external customers that use those outputs. And finally, to identify unintended wastes output by the process. Wouldn't it be nice if every manufacturer in the world actually used this tool and was at least consciously aware of the waste that each process is producing, so that maybe someone within the organization would focus their attention on reducing some of those wastes to the benefit of both their own profit bottom line and the benefit of many intended and unintended stakeholders affected by the process.